Hi everyone, hope you're doing well. How you all feeling today? I just thought I'd quickly jump on and let's see what we got tonight for you today, this afternoon, wherever you are in the world. It's night time in England, so let's see what we got for you. Spirit guides, angel guides, get me into the energy of the collective, please. What messages do you have for my collective, please? Okay, your first card is Transformation, which is a beautiful start. Transformation, you've transformed from this sad, depressed, unhappy, very depressed, very suppressed, dark, sad person. People, some of you, look, this is what you used to be, sad, depressed, unhappy, and then you've transformed, and some of you are quite shocked at how you feel different to what you was. You're looking around, you're thinking, wow, this is beautiful, I feel light, I feel happier. It's like you've emerged from like a... You've been in this cocoon. You've been in a cocoon of life. You felt like your work life wasn't worth living. You felt... And you've just sprung out of this. And look at your wings. Can you see your wings? You're ready to fly. You're ready to go. Transformation. If you're not in this energy and you feel like you haven't transformed, have patience. It will come. The ones that have transformed, you've had patience and you've transformed with patience, with time, with energy. You've actually released a lot. Now look, when you do something, you have to plant the seed and then it doesn't grow straight away. You got to water it, you got to nurture it, and then slowly, 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 it grows into a flower. This is what some of you have become. You've nurtured yourself, you've had patience with yourself, you've transformed, and you've come out very nice, and you're getting your power back. You're getting your power back, which is very nice. You're powerful, you're getting there. If you're not there already, you're getting there. Have patience with yourself. But I feel most of you have, you're in this transformation energy. You transformed. Spirit guides, angel guides, what other messages do you have for my collective, please? What other messages do you have for my collective, please? Messages, spirit guides, angel guides, get me into the energy of my collective, please. Okay, right, you've transformed, you've had patience, you're powerful now, yeah? What you've come out of is, what you've released is this person that has been very, the miser. He's a miser, he doesn't give. He wants to take from you. He doesn't give you nothing. He holds on to money, to love, to feelings. He's emotionally unavailable, but he wants to take from you. And this is what you've let go of. Why? Because you've had guidance. You've had guidance from the universe. That's why you've let go. You've had guidance, you've had protection, you've had help, you've had support, and you've let go of this miser, narcissist, psychopath, whatever you want to, however it resonates with you, whatever you want to call them, be my guest. But you've had guidance, and that's what you've let go of. You feel now you've got possibilities in your life. You feel passionate. You feel possibilities are coming in for you. You're seeing things from above your situation now instead of the lower energies. And not your fault. It's not your fault that you was in that situation. You got sucked in to his or her web, or, and we've all done it. So don't blame yourself. Don't blame yourself. The main thing is that you've transformed. You're getting your, you've got your power back, and you've had your patience and you've transformed. You're getting your power back, and you can see your life now has got possibilities in it, where before you didn't see that or feel that. If you're not feeling that, you will. Spirit guides, angel guides, what other messages do you have for my collective, please? What other messages do you have for my collective, please? What else is coming in for them, or what else do they need to know? Abracadabra with wings, fantastic good fortune and lucky chances. I told you, your luck is going to change. You've done the work. You're going to get rewarded. If you're starting your own business, if you're working, if you're going to change your job, whatever it has to do with money, you're going to have a prosperous business with riches and success. Whatever it is, this could mean anything. If you've got your own business, it's going to rise. If you're going to change your job and work for somebody, you're going to get a huge pay rise. Whatever you're doing with money or thinking about, it's going to benefit you, because you've got abracadabra with wings and the prosperity card. So you're going to get blessed. And you're going to have a shock. Don't wait for this to happen. Let it happen itself. But it's coming to you. I'll leave this out. Wow. Wow, look. This jumped out, you saw it, yeah? You saw it. It's birth. Another gateway appears in view. A new life is unfolding with blessings to you. Can you read that? I hope it's in focus. You see? You're starting a new journey. That's what's this. Some of you have to bless your space at home. Sage yourself, sage, not yourself, well, you can sage yourself. Sage your home, clean the air, yeah? You bless your space at home, office, or even yourself. Some of you maybe still have to clear some energy out of yourself. So some of you are okay, some of you haven't. Let me tell you something before I carry on with this reading, because I was going to say it at the end, but not in my mind, I will forget. Okay, you've done the work, you've healed. The ones that haven't done the work and are still attached to the past, or you haven't healed completely, and you go and meet somebody else and you've still got attachments to the past or to your person, you've still got feelings, or you haven't released it completely and you go and grab a new person, what you're going to do, you're going to attract the same person you had, but in a different body. And they will act exactly the same as your ex, but in another body. That's why you've got to clear yourself. Don't grab anyone quick, because it will end up like the other one, but in a different form, different body. So make sure you really do cleanse yourself, clear the energy, do the work, heal, cry, release it, understand it, learn from it, move on, and then you will attract somebody better, and you will get rid of that sort of person you're attracting. That's why some of you say, oh, I had one before and then I got another one and he was exactly the same, or she was exactly the same as the other one. That's why, because you haven't healed properly, you haven't let go, or you've let go of them, but you're holding on to that. You're suppressing your feelings and you're not releasing it and understanding and taking a lesson from it. So you have to completely release, completely understand it, and completely think, okay, I've learned something from this. I know what I've learned. And don't grab somebody so quick, somebody new, because you will attract the same person, but in a different body. I hope you understand what I mean. I hope you understand what I mean. Oh, let me do these last. Shouldn't have done that now. Right, spirit guides, angel guides. Get me into the energy of my collective, please. What messages do you have for my collective, please? What messages do you have for my collective, please? Spirit guides, angel guides. Get me into the energy of my collective, please. I think you're all doing well. The cards don't want to come out tonight. The first card we got is justice. So that says everything. Justice will be served. Scales are going to be balanced out. Karmic relationships are done and dusted. You're starting a new life. And your person is very sad and very disappointed. This could be you as well. This could be you feeling like this. You could be like thinking, oh, why didn't this work out? I wish it worked out. It didn't work out. And you're looking at the three cups that spilt and you're not looking at the two behind you. You've got love coming in for you. Some of you are not interested in that. You just want this back. And you feel sad. If you don't feel this, you're bored, you're disappointed, you feel... If it's not you, it's your person. Your person is feeling bored, because I've got this here as well. This is here as well. So somebody's discontent and bored. Boredom. Could be you, could be them. But justice will be served. Justice is coming in for you. If you're sad, if you're in this energy of sadness, don't worry, it will all sort itself out for you. You will feel better. Justice is going to happen. Okay? They're going to pay heavily for what they've done to you. Don't ever doubt the universe. I know you want it to happen yesterday, but it's going to happen. It's going to happen when you let go, and it will happen quicker when you let go. Spirit guides, angel guides, what other messages do you have, please? For my collective, what other messages? Okay, good. Right. Okay. Right, I think this is your person. It could be you or your person. Right, take it as it resonates. I'm getting two or three different situations here, right? Like I said, boredom, sadness, disappointment. Some of you feel left out in the cold. If it's not you, if this is you, you're feeling left out in the cold, you feel abandoned, you feel sad, you're wondering why this happened. Some of you have maybe struggling a little bit with money, but if it's not you, your person is going through a hardship financially. They feel discontent, they feel bored, they feel like they've been left out in the cold. Like I said to you yesterday, they're gonna have a tower moment. So things are gonna go awfully wrong for them. And that's where the Justice card comes in. You see, justice is gonna be served for you. So that's how they're gonna feel. However they made you feel, they're gonna feel it tenfold. Don't doubt the universe. The universe works for all of us. It will always bring in justice, universal justice. So if somebody's doing something underhanded and telling you something nice from their lips, but their heart is deceiving you, God reads hearts. Remember, God sees and hears everything. And he doesn't go from your words. God will always read your heart. So make sure, not you, anybody, make sure your words match your heart, what's in your heart. And that goes for actions as well. But they say action speaks louder than words. And that's true. But remember, justice is going to come in. And that's their problem. You have a brand new beginning. Brand new passionate beginning. Whatever your beginning is, it's going to be beautiful. You got the strength. You got the strength to continue your life forward. This is you moving forward. Stronger. Passionately. You've done a lot of releasing and you've had the strength to overcome this pain and start again. New beginnings for you. But I must say this, your person is spying on you. Spying on you. They're watching you. They want to know what you're doing. Because like I said yesterday, they're going to see you happy, celebrating. I believe I said that. Celebrating, happy. New person. Once they see you're doing this, that's when they're going to try and come back and tempt you back. That was yesterday's reading. Today they're spying on you. They're feeling left out in the cold. This cycle has ended though. Cycle has ended. I just saw the World card. Cycle has ended. You've closed out the cycle. You're moving on. Some of you are still resting. If this is not you, this is your person is going through some lonely time. Maybe they're on their own. They feel alone. They feel abandoned. They're bored. They're discontent. They're having lack of something. Lack of money. Lack of friends. Lack of family. Lack of something. But they're resting. They're not resting in a good way. They're hurt. But they're healing. Or they're gonna start healing. But it's a long process for them. They realize what they had with you. They were happy with you. They had this happy home, happy whatever. They're still waiting for you, or you could be a distance from them. But I believe this is, they know now what you've done for them, how you was with them. Their life is going wrong. And their life is going wrong. Sorry about my neighbours if you can hear them. They're very loud. I do tell them off. But they just carry on. Yeah, you're moving forward. You got passion now. Your passion is coming back. You're abundant on your own. You got money coming in. You're just happy. If you're on your own and you're single, you're happy, you're passionate. You're getting on with it day to day. You're living your life. You're looking at what's around you and you're grateful. You're truly grateful for how you feel today and what you've got around you. You're truly happy. Your money's going to start growing as well. Your money's going to start growing. You're going to start seeing it coming in. I don't know if you was with your person and you noticed your money's going down when you was with that person. And now you're seeing that your money's coming back up and you've got it back again. Or you're trying to get it back again. You will. Wheel of Fortune is turning in your favor. Everything you want, money-wise, anything you want is coming in for you. You're starting a brand new journey. Brand new journey. You got the sun shining on your new life, your new path. Some of you are acting like I'm happy, like a child. You're leaving it all behind you and you're saying, I'm gone, I'm out of it, I'm happy. You got the sun shining on your new beautiful journey. Your person has been hiding stuff from you, secrets, or if it's not them, this is you. You're using your intuition now. You're understanding what you had was just a very weak foundation, and you can see now what you was with. If that doesn't resonate with you, your person is trying to go within now because they've had a tower moment. So whatever they've been doing or whoever they've been with, the lightning has struck their foundation and it's gonna crumble for them. It's gonna fall apart. Because like I said before, I pulled these cards. What they've done to you, they're gonna get it back tenfold. They thought they had a lot of options. They was charging forward to their new options, to their new whatever they were doing. Got options, I'm this, I'm brilliant because my person showed me how amazing I am. Narcissistic traits. So they charged away quickly, run away, and they thought they've got options. But little did they know, they're gonna pick up a snake along their way. And now they're feeling stuck in their own life because of their choices they made. Or they could be in prison. Whatever resonates. You've transformed. You've had a death and a rebirth. You've got two of the same cards. You've had a death, you've transformed. Or if not yet, you're going to end this relationship if you're still in it. You're the one that's going to say that's it. Because you can't stay in this energy. This is time for endings. Endings and new beginnings. If you want to stay in this, you can. Free will. But you'll repeat the same thing. Nothing will change. Nothing will change. And I know some of you don't want to hear it, but like I said, I'm honest, I'm going to tell you the truth because I'm here to help you. You stay in it, you'll repeat the same cycle over and over and over again until you understand that it's not working. So you don't want to keep attracting the same person. And someone is juggling. Maybe it's your person, maybe it's you, juggling two jobs, two things. Let's see what the next card is. Spirit guides, angel guides, what other messages do you have, please? Some of you are still in this energy of juggling. You don't know whether to have them back. If you're with them, if you're still with them, you don't know whether to let them go or stay with them, or you don't know what to do. Some of you, not all of you, some of you have done the work. Amazing. That's it. You're okay. But there's a few of you that are still juggling. You don't know, shall I take them back? Shall I give it another go? Maybe they'll change. Maybe this, maybe that. Yeah? This is maybe just the five of you, but I know somebody, this is for somebody. This is a message for somebody. You're juggling, you don't know what you're doing. Stay, go, give them another chance. Maybe this time they're different. Maybe this time they learned their lesson. I'm not gonna say any more than that. You got the devil there. Your devil will not change. They will not change. This was meant to end. You're meant to cut the chains and go on your journey. Don't please them, because you can't please them. And pleasing somebody else is not going to make you happy. And in the end, it becomes a burden when you please somebody all the time. They're not pleasing you, but you're pleasing them. It's not fair. You can't do that. Okay? I think you're trying to fight off this energy, but you feel chained and bound. Then you've got to do some cord cutting. I've got a cord cutting video on my, it's unlisted, so you can't get it, but if you want it, you can email me, and I just charge not a lot of money for it, if you want to clear it. But you're going back to the same thing. Like I said, you stay with them, you're going to repeat the same thing. And they only want to keep you with them because they see you you're different. You're changed, you're abundant, you transform. They don't like it because they can't change themselves. They need to change themselves. Spirit guides, angel guides, get me to the energy of my collective, please. What other messages do you have for my collective, please? Too many. Spirit guides, angel guides, what other messages do you have for my collective, please? Give me one message, please, one message for my collective. Right, some of you need to talk to God, right? You need to communicate with God. You need God to help you. You need to ask Him to help you if you're in this stuck energy, or you still feel tied to your person, yeah? Because I think some of you believe that they're going to be different. They're not, trust me. They're not going to be different. They're going to be still in this energy. Talk to God, ask them to help you. Ask God to help you. The ones that are still in this, you're still in this toxic, draining, life draining energy. You've got to get out of it, otherwise the universe will destroy it for you. Please come out of it. See your worth, see what you are, see you're a beautiful soul. Don't let nobody do that to you. You do not deserve that treatment by anybody. You don't. Love yourself more and think, I'm not accepting this. If it's to do with finances and you can't get away, I understand that. But at least while they're there, do the work, try and get over them. And then something's going to happen for you. Something good will happen for you. And then you can go. Okay, there's always a way out. Always. Ask God to help you. Ask God to help you and He will show you the way. The ones that are still in this. If you're living with them and you can't get away, then okay, ask God to help you. Okay? Because I believe this message was for somebody that's still, maybe you're feeling stuck, you're stuck to this devil and you do want to cut free and you do want to change and you do want to transform, but you can't because of your circumstances. So that's what I'm getting. You want to go, but you can't. Talk to God, trust me. Anyway, beautiful souls, I hope you enjoyed this reading. And I love your comments. I love reading all your comments. If I can answer back, I will. But you know, as you know, I always put the love heart there to say I love your comment. But I read them all. And that's it. I'm going to have a relaxing evening now because I'm feeling a bit tired. So I send you many blessings on your journey. And until we meet again, take care.